This illustration is about breaking off a cube from ground. Here the figure shows two identical cubes, each of mass m, connected by a light spring of force constant k. Here the spring is initially compressed and the cubes are connected by a thread with the spring compressed. We are required to find the initial compression in a spring so that on burning the thread, finally the lower cube will break off from ground. So here we can directly write, when we burn the thread, per block will bounce and it should bounce to a level so that the spring force on the lower block should balance its weight. So we can write, if finally elongation in a spring is y, to break off lower block, here we can directly use ky should be equals to mg. And we can say if initial compression is x, by work energy theorem, we can write the initial kinetic energy in the blocks is zero. If initial compression is x, then due to spring, block m will bounce to a height x plus y because we have taken y as the final elongation. So in this situation, work done by gravity will be minus mg x plus y. Spring will release its potential energy, that is plus half kx squared. That is a positive work done by spring on block. And it will absorb an energy minus half k y square, as y is the final elongation in it. And finally, the upper block will come to rest before, just before the lower block will bounce. So in this situation here, we can write the value of k y as mg. So in this situation, if we further simplify this mg, we can write as k y. So this is minus k y x minus ky square plus half kx square minus half ky square is equals to zero. Here, this k gets cancelled out throughout, and in this situation, if we further simplify, this will be a quadratic equation rewritten as x square minus 2xy minus 3y square is equals to zero. So if we solve this quadratic equation, the value of x, we can see it will be minus b, this 2y plus obviously minus sign we can discard. This is the root of b square, this 4y square plus 12y square divided by 2. So the value of x we are getting is, this will be y plus this will be 2y, so this 3y. The value of y is mg by k, so this can be written as 3mg by k. That will be the final result of the problem. Later when you will study oscillations, then in case of simple harmonic motion, you will be able to get this result directly without using work energy theorem. So right now, as the illustration is taken to explain work energy theorem, we are solving it by using this method. The same question you can find as an illustration in the topic of simple harmonic motion, where directly it can be obtained.